Hello student, how are you? Welcome again to my class. Today we continue lesson 5 and topic 2. And the topic title is Volunteer Activities. In this topic, we are going to give suggestions. We are going to suggest. Our target language is why don't we donate our clothes to the community center? So our focus will be why don't we? Okay, why don't we do this? Why don't we do that? So that will be our focus today. And you know the word donate. Donate means to give something freely from your heart. Like donating your blood. I donated my blood several times. Maybe when you get older, you're going to donate your blood too for helping others. That is what we call volunteering. Okay? So we're going to say, why don't you? We're going to suggest our friends, our loved ones, to do something for others. Do you got my point? Okay. Read and check. You're going to read and check. Have you done these volunteer activities? So let's see. There are 6 activities. Maybe you did 1 or 2 or more than 2. So let's check that. Which one you did. Like number 1, it says clean up a street. Yes, sometimes in our school we used to go and clean up the street, be a helping hand to the community. Next one, serve food to the homeless. Yes, giving out food or serving like a waiter or waitress, but you are helping others, especially homeless people, people who do not have their house or enough money to eat food. So we serve them food as a volunteer work. It's really a great job to do. It's a really a great volunteer work. Let's move on to the third one. Paint pictures on a wall. Yes, in some countries, they express themselves by painting pictures on the wall. Pictures that give some lessons to others. It's not so common in Korea, but in other countries, they express themselves by painting on a wall. Or sometimes they paint the dirty walls, put a clean paint, make them white. We call it whitewash. Okay? And the other one is donate, that we learned before, donate old clothes. Yes, I think we need to donate our clothes. Other one, number 5, read books for children. That's very interesting. If you read books for children, that is double benefit. You're reading books and as well as you are satisfying yourself with the book reading. And the last one is plant flowers at a park. That's my favorite. You know that I love planting. What do? You plant flower. Planting flower at the park will give people happiness. When they walk in the park, they feel happy, relaxed. That is how we help out our community. So the question stands the same. Have you done these volunteer activities? So you can check on your book which one you did. And then later you can tell me, teacher, I did these activities. It's good to share. Good job, student. So we can make the questions also with the same pattern. Like, why don't we? We can use that one. Why don't we clean up a street? Why don't we paint picture on a wall? Why don't we read books to children? Why don't we serve food to the homeless? Why don't we donate old clothes? Why don't we plant flower at a park? Good, right? We can use this way. We can make a lot of examples with this. Listen and write. You have to fill in the blanks. What will the speaker do? Okay? So, the sentence is, they will blank their town street. Let's go into the dialogue and listen and then write down, fill in the blanks. Okay? And the girl says, what kind of volunteer activities can we do? So she asked a question to her friends, classmates, what kind of volunteer activities can we do? And the boy says, why don't we, that is our target language, why don't we clean up town street? Wow, that's amazing. And the girl says, all right, let's do it, right? So, can you fill in the blanks? What they will do? They will clean up their town street. Good work, student. Let's move on. Look at the screen. Look at the poster and fill in the blanks. So keep your books open and then let's do some kind of writing, okay? It's start like this. We want your help. Yeah, whenever you do some volunteer work, there's always a poster. It says, we want your help. And the first sentence says, let's blank money and help the people. Let's blank money and help the people of Maple Town. The name of the town is Maple Town. And the second one is, where? At the blank, when? May 3rd, underneath it says, please blank your items and donate them. Let me walk you through the dialogues and then you can fill in the blanks. Are you ready? Good student. Let's try. Good morning, students. As you know, there was a big fire in Maple Town. Why don't we raise money and help the people there? To raise money. You heard the song. You raise me up. Yeah, that's mean to raise. You can raise a pet, right? You can raise a child. And you can raise, right? Good. Come to our special event at the school grounds on May 3rd. Please bring your items and donate them. We will sell your items. When I was teaching in elementary school, students bring their items from their house and they sell it for a very cheap price and donate that money to the charity. That's a good community volunteer activity. Then we will give all the money to Maple Town. Why they want to give the money to the Maple Town? Yes, because there was a big fire, right? Good job, student. Please give a hand to people in need. Give a hand mean to help. It's a really good example. If your mom is very busy doing house chores, cleaning, cooking, and then she can ask you, can you give me a hand? It's mean, can you help me? Please remember that expression, to give hand. It's mean to help. Can you give me a hand? Very good, student. So let's go and fill in the blanks. The first one is, let's raise money and help people of Maple Town. Where? At the school grounds. When? May 3rd. Please blank bring, right? Bring your items and donate them. Excellent job, student. You did very well. Let's move on to the second part. Look at your screen and you can see volunteer day plan. And what it says, what will the student do on volunteer day? Check the answer. So you have to check volunteer day plan. What place? Nursing home. We also, in our school, we have a nursing room. If you get sick, you get some assistance from the nurse. Every school have a nurse. But nursing home is different. They nurse people, okay? Activities. What kind of activities they have? Plant flowers, cook food, serve food, read books, sing songs, play music. Really good activities. I think you can do that. Some of you students can play some musical instrument. Some of you can sing very well. Some of you may be good at reading books, planting flowers, cook food, serve food. In my case, I will choose plant flowers, cook food, serve food, read a book, sing songs, play music. It's a bit difficult for me. So other ones I can do. So are you ready? Listen to the dialogue and then check your answers. Okay? Ready? Let's do it. And the boy says, next Wednesday is a volunteer day. We cleaned up the park last time. What are we going to do this time? And the target language, the girl says, why don't we visit a nursing home and clean it up? Good activity. And the boy says, that's not a bad idea, but I want to do something fun. Why don't we hold a party for the people there? Wow, that's amazing. They will love it. So let's keep going. That's a good idea. What can we do at the party? We can serve some food. And how about playing some music? Awesome. Can you play the piano? I can't play the piano. I really wish that I can play some musical instrument. Girl says, and I can play the cello. It sounds like a good plan. Did you get the answer? Yes, please check. What they are going to do? They're going to go nursing home. They're going to play some music. And then, so you get the answer. Did you check the answer? Serve food and play music. Look at your screen and you can see a pattern. Our pattern is there with the blank. It says, why don't we blank for the people there? What is the answer, student? Can you guess? Let me know. Yes, they says, why don't we hold a party? Hold a party, hold a concert. It means to have a concert, to have a party, to hold a party. We use a hold a with various words like hold a meeting, hold a party, hold a concert, and so on. So let's check the good expression in this lesson. That's not a bad idea. What does that mean? It means it's a good idea, right? But it says that's not a bad idea. Very good. And another one is, I want to do something fun. Sometimes you are really fed off. Fed off mean tired, sick and tired of doing the same routine work. And you said, today I want to do something fun, something different. Okay? That's the meaning of the expression. And the third one is, serve some food. You can serve drink, you can serve food, you can serve someone with something. Okay? To serve means to do something for others. Okay? Good. Let's move on to our last part. My favorite part. our worksheet, because I make this worksheet for you guys so you can learn how to write and understand all the expressions. So on one side, similar pattern, topic two, volunteer activity, suggesting why don't we donate our clothes to the community center. Underneath, the same thing, you can make a lot of sentences with that. I suggest you to make sentences like, why don't we clean up a street? Okay? So please write down all the sentences. It's good for studying English. If you don't want, it's okay. It's fine. Underneath, the same fill in the blanks and the dialogue. And the other side is our final activity. And the target language is, why don't we do volunteer work? Blank. B says, sounds good. What can we do there? And A said, we can blank. So you have to write down two of them. I already did picture number one. Let's do it together. And then you can follow the same pattern for picture number two and three. You can do it, student. I believe in you. Okay, let's do the picture number one. It says, why don't we do volunteer work at the children's hospital? Sounds good. What can we do there? We can play music for the sick children. Wonderful activity. If you look at picture number two, it's already many details are there. Let's take care of the dogs and cat at the animal care center. So can you make this conversation? I believe you can do it. And so on for the third one. I hope, student, that you learn a lot today from this lesson. It's a very beautiful lesson because it's helping others. So today we are learning English and learning how to help others. There are so many kinds of volunteer activities. You can tell me which activities you really want to do in the future. It will be really great. For now on, our time is up and it's time to say goodbye. Please stay safe, keep your mask on, wash your hands several times, keep a distance, be healthy, help others as much as it possible, as much as you can do. Be happy until we meet. Goodbye, student.